I can seem to make up my mind on one thing. I see everything as music, you know? I came from jazz field, but now I've been encountering a lot of different kinds of music. I have played tango with Astor Piazzolla's former musicians, thanks to Gary for that. And now I play classical music with an orchestra, and great orchestra such as New York Phil, NHK Philharmonic, and Osaka Phil, of course, with A.G. Owe, great conductor. And I think that's what gives me the incentive to like keep on moving, because I love things that I can't do, you know? I love things that when I discover something, it's like, oh, what is that? And I try it. And normally, usually, when I try something new, it's not as easy as it looks, you know? So that's what keeps me going as a musician, that I listen to different kinds of music and I try to play as authentically as I can. That's a very important thing. You can fake it, but then if it's not real, people know, oh, that's not quite Mozart. No, that's not quite Dixieland. That's not quite Latin. So what do? I pick one of the best musicians that I can ever play with in that field. And then I steal it from them. Mm-hmm. When I play great Latin music, I play with Portinho, I play with Paquito de Rivera, you know. And when I play straight ahead or a swing, I play with Tain, Christian McBride, Cullen Spann, James Genus, you know, Rafael Marsalis, of course. And then when I play classical music, I play with the right, you know, professionals, and so they can teach me how to do that.
Thank you.
that of course, our musicians, my guys, my friends, are like me. They will love the challenges. So this is the big band. We have a score, we have the music around me, but we never play as it's written. And I hate that, you know, like, oh, you know, you were a little flat. Okay, let's play this part, it's a little tight, which is good. You know, that's one way to play. But then I say, you know, it's jazz. And jazz is about, like, your life, you know. You never know what's going to happen. You never know what's going to happen next moment. I mean, that's... And people, some people are so scared of that. And some people are so fond of it. They like the thrill. They like to find out when it gets there, you know. So jazz is like essence of jazz is about improvising. So, you know, you cannot do the set improvisation, which is not improvisation anymore because you planned it already. This is a place, you know, Osaka Billboard. Was the place for me to play jazz. And of course, doing concerts are great because you can do lightings and you can do a lot of effects. And that's the way to compensate for the loss of the intimacy, you know. Because at the jazz club, you can actually feel the vibe of the band and you can see how we communicate because it's so close. But in the concert halls, it's so far away. So then we'd have to do something to make it more interesting for people. But over here, we just play, you know, and we have so much fun playing in here. And the great staff at the Billboard, everybody loves music. And the audience, it's so close, and I can't complain. I'm having a great time.
Thank you. Every April 30th, and last April 30th, yeah, it was here in Osaka. We had a great time. So many great musicians. You know, Herbie Hancock, of course, and Wayne Shorter, and Dee Dee Bridgewater, and John Scofield, and Esperanza Spalding, and Dionne Warwick was there last year. A lot of great musicians. It was really a nice time. I think jazz is really, you know, people starting to realize how effective it is, you know, in communicating to people, you know. I always tell people we travel all around the world, and lots of times we can't even say hello in the language of the country that we're playing in, or goodbye, or thank you, you know. But when we play, there's an instant communication, you know. It was like that the first time we came here to Japan, you know. First time I came here, I don't know, maybe 35 years ago. And, you know, it was very, very different. And, you know, I didn't know how to say hello or anything, but as soon as we played, we had instant friends, instant family, you know what I mean? And that's what music can do. Once somebody is 14 years old and they hear some American play music and they make a connection, they always have that connection. So if somebody tries to tell them later on in their life, you know, these Americans are bad, or this, you know, you should feel a distance, they say, it's too late. I've already made a connection, you know, and I think that's the first step towards people getting together and getting along. I've been coming to Osaka for good number of years, man, and it's such a great city, you know. And I'm not just saying that because I'm in Osaka. I mean, it really is and has traditionally been a very important city for jazz, you know. Thank you.
Thank you. A two-day free event, the 17th Takatsuki Jazz Street 2015, took place in May at 57 venues. More than 120,000 people came to hear more than 750 acts perform in venues, ranging from intimate cafes and street-side stages to Takatsuki's main concert hall and a special outdoor stage produced by FM Kokolo. Performers included the New York Voices, trumpeter Terumasa Hino, and quality bands featuring musicians from the United States, Australia, South Korea, and other countries. So bad.